Automation is a game changer for digital transformation. And in fact, RPA is the fastest growing type of automation in the industry. Companies look to automation to drive resilience. They try to drive down costs. They try to improve the daily work lives of employees. And there's no better example than what is happening at Salesforce. They're early on in their RPA journey. They're reducing friction and they're reducing costs every day with RPA. So I'd like to bring in Wing Yu, the SVP of Business Technology at Salesforce, to join me to talk about their journey with RPA. Wing, thanks for joining me today.
Hey, Kevin, great to see you. Thanks for inviting me to share our automation journey with you.
I'm excited about this. I'd love to hear a little bit about how long you've been at Salesforce and what your role is there.
Sure thing. I've been at Salesforce for nearly 8 years coming up. And I'm responsible for all aspects of IT operations, from global end user support to application infrastructure services, and also mergers and acquisition, integrating all of the acquired companies into our ecosystem.
And that's great, Wing. Now, can you tell us a little bit about what problems you're trying to solve with automation at Salesforce?
Yeah, sure thing. So Salesforce is running at 133 cities around the world. We're growing at a tremendous rate, 20% annual growth every year for the last 20 years. We also acquire 5 to 10 companies a year. So really what keeps me up at night is how to scale and meet the growth of the business. And to keep up with the growth, we deliver a lot of projects on our various Salesforce systems and we build lots of integrations across them. But ultimately, we're still relying on humans to be the glue to our processes, mapping external and internal processes across our different silos and systems. We're also really focused on well-being for the company. We're settling into the 10th month of the pandemic, and we need to focus on automation more than ever to provide relief for our people. We need to give them time away from the manual repetitive work and focus on creative work and innovation. We also want our knowledge workers around the world to be working on innovation, creating new products and services, and not just doing manual routine work. This is where the bots come in, right? The digital workers, they work around the clock. They even work on the weekends and we don't have to pay overtime, which is a great thing.
That's fantastic. And you know, anyone early on in their journey has to figure out how they're going to operationalize automation. And you've done a great job with something called Automation Studio. Can you tell us about that approach and the operationalization of how you're putting these practices into play?
Yeah, certainly. We're very focused on building the foundation, what we call the Center of Excellence for Automation Studio. We're working with your team to upgrade our platform to 8/2019 in this coming quarter and really stay in line with our partners on the joint product roadmaps. We're also focused on governance, our intake process, the phase gates, the definition of done, and self-service lifecycle management to build reusable components. Change management process is key and building a repeatable runbook so that we can deploy bots at scale. And we're also looking at templates and, you know, how can we use bots to do things like code review, use bots to support error handling, logging, even accessing our single sign-on solution, and building adapters and connectors to common interfaces like Google Sheets and Excel. And we're also building some key partnerships with early adopters with automation. We're focusing on finance, HR, and our compliance departments and building some really great relationships there.
It's really great. You're looking at kind of big problems to solve, but starting small and really looking at the areas for quick payback, it sounds like. Can we talk a little bit about some of the outcomes you're seeing? You don't have a huge number of bots, but the bots you have in production are really producing some great outcomes for you right now.
Yeah, it's great. We are focusing on starting small and getting it right. And we've delivered 10 bots in production already with 50,000 hours saved. So that's great traction for us to keep moving down this journey. And we're also working to build out our code development model to scale automation. So it doesn't have to be only done by IT. We've implemented solutions here to reduce SOX risk, address some of the first line of defense testing that we're putting in place to mitigate those risks, and certainly before our internal and external auditors find the problems.
It's fantastic. You know, it's only 10 digital workers, but that number, 50,000 plus hours saved, is really impressive. And I'd love to get a little more detail on one of the examples. And, you know, finance is just a great, I guess, place to really look at the before after. So can you take us through the finance example?
Yeah, certainly. Here's an example of where RPA really comes into play and makes it very effective for us. This is a vendor invoice processing workflow. As you can see, it's a seven-step process and it cuts across seven different applications across Salesforce, Oracle, and Excel. And we partner with the finance team to automate this process, really leveraging the bots to reduce our accounts payable cycle, reducing error rate, and work anytime, as I mentioned before. Really a great use case for us.
You know, what I love about this one is, you know, the employee experience is drastically altered with something like this, where, you know, instead of doing the same thing over and over again, you've got people in finance that benefit greatly from, you know, the streamlining of those processes, especially at quarter end or anything like that. So talk a little bit about what the impact has been to the employee experience for the finance team here.
Yeah, they love it. They're just clamoring for us to do more for them. And we're actually working with them to and do some co-development so that we can get more bots built and automate more of their processes.
That's great. So at this point, you know, there's folks out there that are wondering, what have you learned early on in your journey? So any best practices or advice that you can share that, you know, people watching this right now could really benefit from?
Absolutely. So as we may know, trust is our number one value at the company. We safeguard our customer data. It's the most important thing we do. And after a couple of iterations, we learned that we needed to build the right lead time to ensure that we have the right profiles set for the digital workers. And initially, we were looking to clone existing profiles that we had for people. And we found out that we needed to take a step back and look at the developing and defining an approval and profile creation process all the way through the delivery lifecycle and build least privileged access profiles so that we can reduce the lead time for us to get these bots into production. We also have worked a lot with aligning with the different departments to ensure that that our automation is aligned to application roadmaps, future releases, and that we ensure that we have the right ROI and also eliminate tech debt because we want to put our focus and resources on the ones that on the automation that give us the highest return on our investments. And really continue to ensure that we have a smooth change management process for future changes on those product roadmaps. We also spend a lot of time thinking about how to ensure that we set up our test environment for delivery. So mimicking the data, the integration, and the right conditions for the process to be automated from dev all the way through to production. The COE is focusing on reusable components, how to build bot shells and to really enable us to scale and growth, especially as we move into this co-development model and automate, right? We also need to use the automation tool to automate our delivery process as much as possible, doing code reviews, deployments, even password updates.
That's tremendous. You know, the trust factor is so huge because, you know, people in general are averse to change. And so if you can show them as part of building that trust, kind of the what's in it for me, how am I going to benefit? It sounds like you've got that down. And then the governance factor with the COE seems like the best way for you to feel comfortable moving forward, just because you know that we're not going to, you know, open up, you know, issues or create sprawl or anything like that. Is that safe to say?
Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. Okay, so final question here, Wing, is, you know, really what's next for your RPA journey? You've got this great automation studio practice going. Where are you going to take it?
Well, we're going to continue to build out our center of excellence, really delivering high value RPA use cases. But beyond RPA, we're also looking at the broader framework of automation what not only kind of what our partners offer in this space, but also how it works with our Salesforce platform, with Lightning workflows, with MuleSoft integration. Kind of how do we tie it all together to deliver the highest value use cases for the company? We're also looking at where we're going with AI, machine learning, natural language processing, and how everything fits together. We're excited about process discovery bot and looking at how we can identify other even high value use cases. The RE personal assistant coming with A2019, we're excited about that as well. In short, we're really looking to enable the entire company on automation. How can we deliver value, improve productivity for everyone as we aggressively grow and scale the company?
It's fantastic to see the vision, Wing. And just, you know, a couple of closing points from me. It sounds like, you know, Salesforce has really benefited from your leadership in establishing a vision. Like, how is this really going to benefit the company long term? And then operationalizing it by showing the value, whether it's before and after, or just showing how you're reducing friction. And then, you know, building that trust, that one still continues to resonate with me, is how you build trust by whether you show the what's in it for me, or you use the COE to manage within guardrails and governance, really allows you to proceed with confidence. So just amazing, amazing progress in such a short period of time. Wing, thank you so much for being with us today. And for those of you watching, check us out at automationanywhere.com for more information on how we're doing this with digital transformation every day. Thanks, everyone.